According to a statement from FDC Secretary General Nathan Nandala Mafabi, dated 7th August 2023, the party has withdrawn Ssemujju Nganda with immediate effect from the position of party whip in parliament. The following were copied in the letter: the Speaker's office, Ssemujju Nganda, the opposition chief whip, and the Mawokota South legislator Yusuf Nsibambi. Nsibambi, whom we met at parliament, accepted the appointment, saying his leadership will focus on peace and reconciliation in the party fused with conflicts.
So we thought as parliamentarians that we really need to have a participation and active involvement in whatever is going on. So I can assure you that we are trying to ensure that at least our people get what they expect of us, the liberation of this country and change that cannot be achieved when you have infighting. So our basic responsibility as parliament, as an organ, as a caucus, is to ensure that we go back to Nagye Nankumbi and the other faction at Katonga, so we put our heads together as members of the same family. Specifically, that is why I accepted this kind of responsibility.
The Mawokota South legislator says his ears are widely open for the two factions and ready to chip in at any point as a mediator, being a senior member of the party.
Coordinate my colleagues here in parliament and also the elders and the membership generally of FDC, so that at least this matter is here settled and on forge ahead. There are critical issues which were raised by the group at Katonga, specifically Dr. Besigye expressed whatever shortcomings, as parliament were not being so active.
Nsibambi says Ssemujju's leadership lost touch with Nagye Nankumbi administration and his sacking was inevitable.
The leadership in Nagye Nankumbi believe that they are not closely connected with the leadership in parliament, and that is it. It has nothing to do with appeasement or because there are no tangible benefits whatsoever.
Ssemujju has traded counter accusations with his tormentor on corruption, party mismanagement, and under table dealings with President Museveni. In his response, Ssemujju scoffed at Mafabi for firing him, saying it's a deliberate effort to chase away all radical kingpins in the party who give NRM sleepless nights.
This was just a matter of time, because in our earlier meeting with Amriat, he told FDC MPs that Ssemujju Nganda was talking too much and he was causing you other MPs problems. So it's just given that Museveni would tell him that, please, I no longer want Ssemujju, is causing me too much trouble. In fact, me, I was waiting for this. First of all, I was elected by the FDC National Executive Committee. Amriat and Nandala have no right to sack me like they are purporting. But also, there is nothing in being the FDC whip in parliament. If they want it so much, I will give it to them. They didn't even have to sack me like they are purporting. Because my major responsibility is to represent the people of Kira municipality. They were already uncomfortable. And by the way, it started much earlier, even with the elections. Amriat has been so incompetent that he even fears competition from his own people. I think now he will become a very big leader now that Ssemujju has been disturbing him, is no longer the whip, and I congratulate him.
A section of FDC legislators led by Atkins Katushabe, the MP for Bukonzo West, have denounced Nsibambi's leadership, saying his appointment was not made in good spirit. Katushabe emphasized that FDC needs healing, not reshuffle at a time.
The task at hand is to redeem FDC. FDC is like a house that you see from a distance. You, who is getting into a neighborhood, you see some smoke going up or some flames going up the roof.
Yes, what this means is, first of all, as a leadership and the lead and the political leadership in general, cutting across all spheres. I don't think dropping a leader amounts to what people would call someone being denied opportunity to serve. These are just normal routine deployments that cut across different political circles, depending on the leadership that is responsible for giving those positions?
I think I would appreciate FDC, one, for introducing Honorable Ssemujju Nganda into the Parliament of Uganda. Now, it's upon their own interests. If they so wish, and that they have wished now, to withdraw him out of Parliament, I'll only congratulate Honorable Ssemujju for serving under that capacity in the Parliament of Uganda.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.